The music we call jazz has been around for about 85 years, and the music that led up to it, ragtime, was in place probably 50 years before that. Jazz piano has mirrored all of the changes in this evolving period. We find as much stylistic variety in the brief but rich history of jazz piano as occurred in classical piano over the last 200 years. The artistry of each of the great jazz pianists is as distinct one from the other, as are the respective keyboard manners of Bach, Chopin, and Debussy. But what the jazz people have had in common is a tradition of rhythmic improvisation and obsession with the beat. They invented ways of pushing it forward, holding it back, displacing it, layering it, even sometimes hiding it. Jazz was originally a dance music, and in almost all jazz, the beat needs to be compelling enough to get a normal foot to tapping. The rhythm, the tradition of improvisation, and the melodic vocabulary, all of which have largely come from African American culture, these are what have made jazz and jazz piano. This is a piece called Pasquinade, a Caprice, by Louis Moreau Gottschalk, a New Orleans composer and concert pianist, who wrote it in 1862 when he had absorbed from black people in New Orleans the rhythms of black folk music. He had absorbed some of the elementary things at any rate. And in the next section of the piece, which I'm going to play for you, listen to this syncopation. That's the syncopation right there, this here. This became characteristic of a dance called the cakewalk, which by the early 1890s had become something that everybody was doing, white people as well as black people. And it produced a number of popular songs which incorporated that same rhythm. Here's one called At a Georgia Camp Meeting from the 1890s. This is, as I said before, sort of elementary syncopation, and it took another few years before people in Scott Joplin's generation were doubling the syncopation at the level of the eighth note so that it sounded more like this. Maple Leaf was published at the end of 1899. So we have a span that goes back to 1862 with Pasquinade, and 30 years later, the cakewalks, which became popular in the 1890s. And then maybe 10 years after that, the efforts of Joplin and the other ragtime piano players to make it even more complex.